Bueno, primates humanos, hoy tenemos a alguien excepcional, a un simio excepcional, diría yo, a Giacomo Rizzolatti, el descubridor de las neuronas espejo. Algo que en principio parece extraño, ¿no? De entender. Neuronas espejo, ¿qué serán? Bueno, pues intervienen en aspectos tan fundamentales como la imitación, la capacidad de entender a otros, de la toma de perspectiva, aquello que llamamos empatía y que tanto nos interesa. Buenas tardes, Giacomo Rizzolatti. ¿Cómo estás?
Bene, grazie.
Bien.
Thank you.
Bueno, yo llevo, la verdad es que siguiéndote durante muchos años, porque la primera publicación sobre las neuronas espejo no, tiene 10, 12 años, tú me corregirás, ¿no? Al respecto. Pero realmente, ¿qué son las neuronas espejo?
Mirror neurons are a set of neurons which we discovered originally in the premotor cortex of the monkey, and which fire when the monkey make an action and when observe a similar action made by a person. So there is this similarity between the aim of the action made by the monkey and the aim in the observer.
Normalmente sueles decir que, por ejemplo, que tu risa determina la mía, ¿no? Your laugh determines mine.
Well, that's what we discovered recently. Recently, we really discovered what you said now, that we have a center in our brain. Stimulation of the center produces laughing. If I see you laughing, I have the activation of the same neurons. So your laughing produces my laughing.
Bueno, eso es
But
desde
that's
luego.
a scientific proof. It's not
Sí, no, yo mismo he
just
leído,
anecdotes that people.
yo mismo he leído los papers y las revistas
Yes.
científicas y lo he podido comprobar por mí mismo, pero desde luego que es algo sorprendente porque es como si nuestro cerebro emulara las experiencias de lo que ve alrededor.
But what we are saying now is something else, that I end in the same state in which you are. So I am empathic with you. My neurons say, he is happy, I am happy, he is in pain, I am in pain.
Entonces, Giacomo, si tu risa determina la mía, tu enfado también determina el mío. Your anger determines mine too.
So with anger, I don't know. With fear, we know that your fear is understood by me. Not only because I became fear, but I see that you are in fear because you are afraid of her, and I understand it from your face because my mechanism is activated.
Pero estos mecanismos neuronales deben de funcionar con una intensidad más baja, porque si no, cuando yo viera que alguien se corta un cuchillo, también sentiría cómo se corta mi mano. O un cirujano no podría intervenir en una operación quirúrgica si la empatía es excesiva.
Well, the mechanism is obvious in the sense that that you are in pain, I am in pain. But then I have some control mechanism. For example, the surgeon, when operating, have this mechanism which block this and he can operate. But notice that very rarely a surgeon operate on his own relatives
Yeah,
because the mechanism disappear and he became anxious and feel the pain as the daughter or the wife.
Claro, es algo que aconsejan, no operar a tus familiares,
No operar
obviamente.
on familiares,
No
no.
operar a los familiares. Eso es, bueno, es muy interesante también. Pero entonces, ese mismo mecanismo que utilizan los cirujanos, ¿también lo empleamos los humanos con la xenofobia o en las guerras?
Well, in war for sure, because you are instructed not to stop when the other is in pain. With racism, unfortunately, I think so, yes.
Sí,
I would
porque
say yes. The trace is the mechanism in which you try to stop this mechanism and say, no, he's not like me, he's different.
la sociedad está realmente muy interesada en cómo podemos bloquear, cómo podemos frenar esa empatía, cómo es posible que seamos capaces de hacerlo, ¿no? Ante
You know,
situaciones
the
como
problem is
estas.
very complicated because while there is a small group, it's very easy to block it. So if we have 10 immigrants and we have 1,000 people, people like them. They are interesting, they are diverse, and so on. While there are too many, there is a kind of mechanism of defense of your identity. And sociologists know that it's a limit between when you are able to stop your reaction and you accept, and when you are unable to stop, and you become an enemy of the other coming.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
One should be very careful also politically, because a certain number of immigrants, it's good for society, it's good for your brain. But when there are too many, it's very easy that it's ancient mechanism of defense prevail and you have xenophobia.
Y ahí es donde se bloquean o bloqueamos, ¿no?
Yeah, exactly.
Pero ¿hasta qué punto es voluntario este bloqueo?
Well, the mechanism is biological, so it's present. It block in this case of surgeon of the policeman is something that has been learned. It has been taught to them in the school of police. Not to, about the ideology, that's very difficult to say, because some ideology can be very pervasive and say they are bad, they are other ideology are more acceptable.
¿Y tenemos algún antídoto para que la sociedad no bloquee estas neuronas espejo?
I am convinced that our biological mechanism, it's easy to maintain when the enemies or the foreign or the immigrants are not too many. When they are too many, I am afraid that there are other mechanisms of self-defense that become very active. I know that ethologists describe it also in primates, it's the same
thing. Sí.
When there are few primates, they are accepted. When there are many, they start fighting.
Claro, eso nosotros los primatólogos y los etólogos lo explicamos porque necesitamos ver la cara, ¿no? Necesitamos ver la cara de la otra persona. Si son muchos, probablemente no nos dé tiempo a verlos a todos y a conectar de alguna manera con todos ellos.
Yes, that's true. It seems that we are able to accept 120, 150 people. That's... When it's small, we don't recognize as other.
Sí, Roger Dunbar exactly. Habló, ¿no? sobre esto.
Beyond a certain number, you don't recognize as friends.
Pero algo que sabían también los romanos, porque ellos estructuraron y diseñaron los grupos militares. De 100 en 100, ¿no? Lo que se llamaban las
legiones.
Las legiones, ¿no? Eran 100. Y ellos sabían que uno no estaba dispuesto a dar la vida por otro al que no había visto la cara.
So, well, that's very interesting. Yeah, he's right. He's right. He said that Romans,
la centuria. Ellos inventaron la centuria. Pero hay también otro asunto que me fascina. Una vez me escribió un lector y me dijo, ¿y qué pasa con la gente ciega? ¿Las neuronas espejo también se activan por medio del sonido?
No, there is a good experiment on that. Blind people recognize the noise and the activity using ears. So the action of the other are recognized very well.
Sí, yo leí un estudio sobre unos pianistas, ¿no? Que luego tenían que escuchar con vendas o con los ojos cerrados esas mismas melodías y parece que en su cerebro se reproducían las teclas, ¿no? Sabíamos que ya existía un contagio emocional, lo que llamaban el efecto camaleón, ¿no? El camaleón effect. ¿Qué hay de nuevo respecto a ese fenómeno descrito hace muchas décadas ya?
Well, camaleón's effect is a very strange effect because I don't know, you are Italian, you go to Rome, you start to speak in Roman accent, although you are from the north. Then you go to Venice, you start to speak with Venetian accent. And the mechanism, I don't know which is. For sociologists, the mechanism is an attempt to become accepted. Because if you speak exactly as the other people, they think, oh, that's like me.
En primatología hemos descubierto que aquellos que copian a otros son más aceptados.
Es vero,
¿no? Y en el grupo. Y en un experimento muy interesante, unos camareros imitaban a los comensales y los que habían imitado recibían mayores propinas.
¿No? Yeah, it's the same mechanism, but I don't know the neural basis.
Claro. O sea que todavía nos falta mucho por entender de las neuronas espejo, ¿verdad?
Ya. Yeah.
Bueno, las neuronas espejo intervienen en la empatía, pero la empatía no siempre es buena. Hay muchas personas que la usan para hacer el mal a otros.
There is an experiment done in Chicago in which they tested people which are in the jail because they make sadistic. But to be sadist, you have to understand the other is suffering.
Uh-huh.
So they are very good in being empathic. They understand very well that she is in pain, but she enjoy, they enjoy instead of...
Claro.
Claro.
Esa sería la diferencia con una persona
otherwise
normal.
Otherwise will be no statistics. If they don't understand you are in pain, why they should determine maybe?
Quizás por eso se está extendiendo la idea de que aquellos que más éxito tienen tienen un punto de sociopatía o de psicopatía incluso.
Yeah, ¿no? I think the psychopaths have this mechanism which is distorted. So typically for us, if you feel the same as you, you try to help the people. And they try not to help, but to enjoy.
¿Y qué pasa, por ejemplo, si una madre quiere estimular esa empatía o desarrollar esa empatía en sus hijos, ¿no? En sus pequeños?
Yeah.
¿Hay alguna manera en la que puedan entrenarlos? O a nosotros mismos también?
Well, I don't know if it's to train, but certainly the mother has a mechanism, and we also studied, it's called vitality effect, that you have a particular relation with your kids. And I think that what you say to train, if you have empathy towards your kids, your normal mother, and you play with the kids, and you stay, the kids grow with the same type of affect. Mm-hmm. If the mother does not play with kids or is too busy and so on, the kids will be not really very positive towards the other. So it's
claro.
Very important, the first months of life and the environment. If I say the mother, important also the grandmother, the father, but anyway, if there are people who likes you, you like the other people. If you grow with the people who doesn't like you, it's very likely you will be one of those guys who doesn't care.
Y otro entrenamiento que he leído en un paper publicado era que el leer literatura nos obliga a colocarnos en diferentes roles de diferentes personajes que aparecen en el libro y que eso también ayudaría a la empatía.
No, I think that's a good point. I mean, the people who read books practically has much more a large idea of other people. They understand many. If you read Dostoevsky, you have so many different characters.
Uh-huh.
So I think you really can be uh-huh. more empathic with the other people because you have more large horizon of the life. You know only five people in your village. It's hard that you can understand somebody else.
Bueno, como ves, yo estoy replicando un poco tus movimientos. Quizás estoy usando mis neuronas espejo ahora mismo porque has cambiado de postura, yo también.
Podrás, sí. Maybe.
Vamos ahora.
No, but in the social life, it's very easy to see this thing. If uh-huh. somebody does something, one say I want beer, the other say me too, me too, me too.
Claro. Y ahora sobre los animales, porque lo descubristeis en macacos. Así que eso obviamente nos obliga a pensar qué otros seres vivos o qué otros animales también poseen neuronas espejo.
Well, for sure we know that the neurons, mirror neurons are in birds, are in marmosets, are in monkey, are in humans, and now there is recently has been discovered also in two species. One is rodents and the other is bat. De pipistrello.
Con un ancestro común de nosotros
but
muy antiguo.
It's an extremely nice experiment published in Science in Israeli. They have a bat which have to run from one point to another. Then they show another bat to see what's going on at the place cell, the cell of the hippocampus. There are some of them which are social. They become active when they see the other bat. So there are some neurons which only describe where you are. The other describe if me was there.
Uh-huh. Interesante.
That's very recent, last week in Science.
Claro, esto va a traer a la larga o a medio plazo consecuencias en cómo tratamos a esos animales.
Well, that's another issue.
Eso depende de la sociedad, obviamente, ¿no? Pero desde luego que es un buen punto de partida para asemejarnos a otros animales. No sé si te parece.
You know, my point of view is typically if we have many things in common with the animals we like, with things that is like us, poor rats, which are very difficult for us, they are killed every year because there is deratizzazione.
Uh-huh.
We probably have the same thing. Periodically they kill all the rats in a city with
Sí, periódicamente hacen en las ciudades hacen sí, campañas de desratización. Exacto, ¿no? Para limpiar las ciudades. Bueno, y una última pregunta. A ver, ¿cómo los españoles, a la luz de los últimos eventos de tensiones que hay en nuestro país, entre Cataluña y España, tenemos muchas o pocas neuronas espejo? Porque te voy a dar mi opinión, creo que tanto unos como otros estamos bloqueando nuestra empatía hacia el otro colectivo.
Well, you are mentioning people in Barcelona or people in Andalucía?
No, en los dos, ¿no?
Both?
In both.
In both.
Both are blocking this empathy mechanism.
Yes, that's what I meant. That
because,
we
know,
have lack of.
It's clear that if one part of, like Italy, Lombardy or Emilia, reaches that they provide money to the south.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is how the south is using this money. If it's useful, of course, south is right. If they are just stealing and doing nothing, then the north is right. I don't know if the same comparison is here. But in Italy, that's the problem. You give money to the south, and south never develops. Then you say, well, we stop giving money to south.
Sí, bueno, este es un argumento muy antiguo, ¿no? De la Europa del Sur subsidiaria. Pero yo más bien me refiero si hay una falta de empatía entre ambas partes, independientemente de quién sea, independientemente de las ideas, ¿no?
Although some country like Ireland received money from Europe, they really changed from very poor country to a rich country.
Sí. Pero, sí, pero a la hora del mutual understanding, del entendimiento mutuo, obviamente aquí las dos partes están bloqueando su empatía, ¿no? De alguna manera. Y eso es lo que tengo. Bueno,
it's not for a neuroscientist. That's usually asked to a sociologist or to a political scientist.
Bueno, pero eso es lo bonito de la ciencia, que empezamos en un laboratorio y acabamos, ¿no?, deslizándolo hacia la sociedad. No siempre con mucho acierto, pero desde luego que, claro, nos preocupa, ¿no?, cómo el cerebro afecta a nuestra vida diaria y
but
común.
One should be very careful, because otherwise the people say, oh, the scientist said that you have to do that, you know, it's scientifically proven.
Ajá. Por último, sí. Por último, ¿algún consejo que nos pudieras dar para mejorar el desarrollo de las neuronas espejo? ¿Tendrías algún consejo o la empatía?
I think the empathy should be improved, and we have to be very careful to improve it, trying methods and to be kind with the people and so on. But we have been also very careful not to go beyond certain mechanisms that the people became bad people.
Claro, que no lo usemos, que no usemos eso para el beneficio propio, ¿no?, sino para el bien común. Es a eso lo que se refiere.
So the message is try to improve your mechanism, but also tell politicians that they should be careful because there is some limit that then the people become nasty.
Bueno, pues Giacomo, ha sido desde luego que un placer, un gran placer, de primate a primate, muchísimas gracias.
De primate a primate.
Y espero que nos veamos muy pronto.